This video shows how to use Google Sheets and the Mann-Whitney test to do a two-group comparison. Let's begin by accessing the data sheet. And so we're going to scroll down. This is the data sheet we want to access. It's on Google Sheets, and it represents information obtained from a questionnaire about midlife crises. We have these variables: dummy coding of male, female, age, social class, religiosity, whether or not someone predicts that a midlife crisis for himself or herself is very likely, the estimate of the percent of men today in the U.S. who have midlife crises, and the estimate of the percentage of men in the past, about 50 years ago, who had midlife crises. One of the things we like to do when we begin to look at our data in a spreadsheet is to do some error checking with some of the descriptive statistics. So let's begin by going over here and getting the count. And what we're going to do is look at the first column, which is gender, and we're going to look at rows B11 colon B60, because that covers our entire sample. We have a count of 50. No missing data. We then get the average for that column. 52% of the column is male. Let's get the maximum score, 1, and the minimum score, 0. Now let's take each of those four descriptive statistics for our first variable, and let's hold down the mouse and drag it across all the variables. Now we release, and those same four calculations are done for all of the variables. And we can verify that we have a count of 50 for each variable. In other words, no missing data. We can also verify that all of our data are between the assigned norms of maximum and minimum for each variable. What we want to do in this example of an abstract is to compare two groups, male and female, on the basis of some other variable. In this example, we'll do social class, but you may be called upon to use one of the other variables. Notice that we have arranged the data so that all the women are together and all of the men are together. The men occupy rows 11 through 36. The women occupy 37 through 60. So we have 26 males and 24 females. Let's compare the male group and the female group on the variable of social class. So we go up here and we get another average, but this time it's in column D, and we're just looking at rows 11 colon D36 to cover the males. So the average male social class was 2.4. Now let's get the average for the females. Again, average, and it's going to be D37 colon D60. And as we can see, the female average was a little bit higher, 2.8 versus 2.4. Now, is that difference going to be a significant one? We'll have to use an inferential statistic, and that we will cover in the next video.